Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Tech Solution. Before going to start, I want to thank you all for your love and support and to subscribe my channel. If you first time came to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification by clicking on the bell icon. To learn the Python, I will suggest you please watch full video. Otherwise, if you are going to miss something and you are going to forward the video, then you will not understand and miss more points that I am trying to teach you in the Python. Okay, I want to teach you the Python as the first way as possible and more practical way. Today I am going to start string formatting. So what is string formatting? To make sure string will display as expected, we can format the result with the format method. Okay, we have in the Python format method. So the string format, the format methods allow you to format selected part of a string. Sometimes there are part of this that you don't control. Maybe they come from the database or user input. To control such value, add placeholders, just like we are going to use in the curly brackets in the text, and run the value through the format methods. Let's go with the example. It will understand better. We are going to use price, just like a 49, enter, and then text equal to the price of dollars. Okay, now it's close to 73 here. And then we are going to print text dot format and passing the value price. Okay, let's run and see it for the output. Okay, we missed the parenthesis here, and let's run once again. Right, the price of 73, that the curly braces is basically here the placeholder. Okay, the curly braces, open and close curly braces, is placeholder. Okay, now we are going to show the another example. You can add parameter even inside the curly braces to specify how to convert the value. What I'm trying to say here is just like the $73 is there, right? If you want to the particular formats like in the float, then how you are going to put into the curly braces? Let's see the example. Colon 0.2 float, then it will print the price value to after that decimal, two decimal values. Okay, let's run and see. Right, 73.00. if you're going to use 0.3, then it will print to three decimal values. Okay, this is clear. Now we are going to show you how we are going to add multiple values. If you want to use more value, just add more value to the format methods. Let's go with the example. Before this, we are going to remove this one. Quantity equal to 30, enter, then item number to 55, price equal to 7.99, my order equal to I want one curly braces pieces of item number curly braces second placeholder for third placeholder curly braces to two decimal values of the floats dollars. Okay, and then print my order dot format passing the quantity, that is the first placeholder, second is the item number, that is the second placeholder, and third is the price. Okay, listen, what will happen? I want quantity 30 pieces of item number 45 for $7.89. Okay, this first placeholder, that will be 30, there is a quantity. Second placeholder is nothing is the item number, that is 45, and third placeholder nothing is the price, 789. Okay, let's run and see. Okay, I want 30 piece, that is the quantity of item number 45, that is the second placeholder, and 789.200, that is the third placeholder of the dollars. Okay, this is clear now. Now I am going to show you what is index number. Even you can use the index number, a number inside the curly braces that will start with 0 to be sure the value are placed in the correct placeholder. So what we are trying to do it, we are passing quantity, item number and price, right? Instead of that, what we have to do, we can use, it's like in the curly braces we are empty, right? We can use 0. Okay, this is basically the item trying to do, index number, right? This is 0, that will display you okay quantity. Now this is 1, that means item number, second placeholder, and this is 2, this is third placeholder. Okay, let's run and see. Same output will get 30 piece of item number, 45 of 789, your $2, right? Now if you are going to change this like a sheet of 1 then 2, and if you are going to put 1, let's see what will happen, right? See, the now what will happen, the item number, right, this is the second placeholder, right? Before the item number is 45. Now what we use, item number 2, that is the price, right? Then what will happen, this is 79 is the price, right? And we are using 1, right? 0, 1, 2. Okay, now what happened, item number is the 2, right? 1, right? Quantity is 0, item number is 1, and price is 2. Okay, my order of quantity is 0, right? And item number basically is 2, right? That is, now is price is 2, right? That means 789, right? And thus 1 is nothing but is item number, that is here is dollars, that is basically is 45. Okay, this is clear now. Now we'll go with name index. This is index number. Now we are going to show name index. Okay, let's control S and we're going to put in the top. So what is name index? You can also use name index by entering a inside the curly braces. Just like we are use 012, right? Instead of that, we can use the name. But then you must use name when you pass the parameters. Okay, I will show you what is name index. First remove this one and we'll go with the example. My order equal to, I have a first pass car name, it is a model. Okay, model also in the name index. Then we have two name index, one is the car name and second one is the model, that is basically the placeholder. Okay, now we are going to print my order dot format, passing the car name equal to Ford, and then passing the model Mustang. Okay, then what will happen, here is the car name, nothing is a Ford, right? Then it will say I have a Ford and it is a model is equal to Mustang, and it is a Mustang. Let's run and see, right? I have a Ford, that is car name, and it is Mustang, that is model. Okay, this is clear now. Now we am going to show you the more string format. Okay, let's remove this one. Same text equal to for only price colon 2f, 2 decimal places, closes and dollars. Okay, and print text dot format, and price we are passing 49. Okay, listen, see what we'll have, for only price, that is 2 decimal places, that is 49.00 and dollars. Listen and see. price, this is caps here. Okay, let's see once again. Okay, for only $49.00. Okay, this is clear now. Basically, the format matters. Format the specified value and insert them inside the string placeholder. Even the placeholder is defined using only the curly bracket, that I say. Okay, and the format matter return the formatted string. Format method returns the formatted strings. Okay, now we are going to show multiple placeholder. The placeholder can be defined using the name index, as I said, just like a price and car name, right? And even number indexes, just like a 0, 1, 2, or even placeholder. Placeholder basically is, we are going to define is using name index, just like example with the price, okay, car name, and even the number index. Number index, that is 0, 1, 2, like that, and or even empty string also. Empty placeholder, like that. Okay, let's go with the example more on that. Text 1 equal to my name is fname, I am age, space, age, and after that dot format and passing the fname equal to John Shino. The age is 36. Okay, and then print text 1. Okay, what will happen? My name is John Sino, that is the placeholder here, and this is name index. Okay, and I am age is 36, right? Let's run and see. Right, my name is John Sino, one placeholder, and I am 36. This is second one, right? Now we'll go with another example. Txt2 equal to my name is 0, that is a number index I'm showing. Number index 0 and I am placeholder 1 dot format John. Now we are not going to pass name, right? We are going to pass index, number index, age equal to 36. Okay. Now I'm going to print text 2. Okay, then my name is same John and I am 36. Okay. Let's run and see. John, okay, here is the missing John 36. Okay, lessons one again. Okay, my name is John and I am 36. Now we'll go with empty placeholder. Text 3 equal to my name is empty parenthesis and I am empty parenthesis. Okay, dot format John 36. Okay, now we are going to print text 3. Okay, let's run and see. Okay, same out. My name is John and I am 36. This is clear now. For today, that's it. Thank you so much for watching my video. I'm going to post more and more video on daily basis. So if you want to watch my video in future, just subscribe in below bell icon with all. It will notify you when my new video will come. And please don't forget to like and share. We will meet once again in new video with new topic.